Hi everyone, thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. My name is Gregory Merles, and today we're going to be talking about creating and using light functions in UDK. This tutorial is a beginner's tutorial and assumes that you have the basic knowledge of importing assets into UDK as well as creating materials. I'll be making sure to let you guys know of any keyboard shortcuts I use over the course of this video. So let's get started. A light function is a way of taking an ordinary UDK light, like this one right here, and applying a material to the light to allow us to create a cool effect. Now, light functions are used with any of the dynamic lights, so toggleable or movable lights. And a light function is actually a material that has a specific set of parameters that we plug into the light. Light functions have a bunch of different varieties of uses. Some of them can be for creating a stained glass window, or the shadow from a fan or other moving shadows, and as well as flickering lights, which is the example that we're going to be using here. So let's get started in actually creating our light function material. So I'm going to open up our content browser, and as you can see, I've already created this light function material, and I'm going to open it and I'm going to create it as well as show you guys the material that I've created. So before we actually create our material, I have to do some stuff to actually set up our material to be a light function. The first thing we do is click on our preview material, and under the material dropdown right here, under lighting model, I have mine set to MLM unlit. So if you just click the rollout, yours will be set to MLM Fong. Set it to MLM unlit. And the next thing we need to do is go down to our mutually exclusive usage and click used as light function. This will tell the material that this specific material will be used as a light function. Now, you should only have your emissive channel turned on. Now, our material is comprised of 7 nodes. It's very simple. We have a time node, 2 cosine nodes, 2 add nodes, a sine node, and a floor node. And I'll explain all of these. So, a cosine node is simply just a cosine wave that's going to be moving throughout the material, and we're adding 2 of them together. Now, the special thing about these cosine nodes is that we currently have them set to a period that is a random number. So this one's set to, you know, like a 5 point with a bunch of numbers, this one's set to 1 point with a bunch of numbers, and our sine node is set the same. So essentially what's happening here is that we're creating a random fluctuation of a wave formation to create a flickering effect. And you can see our flickering effect right here with this little plane, and it's turning on and off at a random interval. So I'm going to create a time node. To create a time node, you come up to your material expression and you type time. And I'm just going to click and drag him into the window. You can move this guy around by holding control on your keyboard and left click and moving around with your mouse. I'm also going to need cosine nodes. And to get to a cosine node, you can either type into your material expression, or I'm going to right click and go to math, new cosine node. And I'm going to plug this guy into here. And if we right click, excuse me, if we left click mouse onto this little black box next to the cosine, you can see that we're currently having a flickering that's going at a normal pattern, just on and off with shades of gray in between. So if you click this guy, you can see that our period is currently set to 1. And I'm going to set this guy to something like 5.123456. The numbers that you input don't really matter, it just matters that they're random. And the reason for that is that we want this to create a random fluctuation in the time when we add them together. So, and we also don't want this number to be too high, otherwise we'll have too long of a period between light and dark. We don't want that to happen. So I'm also going to just Control C and Control V and create a second cosine node, and I'm going to make this guy 3.66666666. All right, and I'm going to add the time node into this. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use create an add node. And to create an add node, you can hold A on your keyboard and left mouse click, or you can type it into your material expressions. And the third way you can reach an add node is to right click and go down to utility. You go to math, new add. So we have an add node right here, and I'm going to plug these guys in. And if we look at our old expression, we also need a second add node and a sine node. So, drag that guy back down. So I'm just going to Control C and Control V, have an add node. I'm going to plug this guy in here. And I'm going to right click, and I'm going to go to math, new sine. I'm going to plug this guy in here. Click and drag. and I'm going to give this guy a random interval of, let's say, 1.575757. I don't know, sometimes I just like to play with the keyboard, and that gives me a chance to kind of enter a random number. All right, now we have our add node, and if we turn this guy on here, and we plug him into here. Actually, I'm going to grab all these guys, and I'm going to hold Control and Alt and left mouse click so I can marquee select all these guys, and I'm going to move them up, and I'm just going to delete my old function here. Turn this guy off. And if we plug our add node currently into our emissive channel, we forgot to plug in our time into the sine node. There we go. You can see that we're having kind of like this fading in and out, and it looks all right. But the thing is that lights don't really kind of fade in like that. That kind of looks more like a dimmer. What we need is something that's going to take the values and kind of push them more towards the light or the dark. So what we need is a floor node. So I'm going to come up into our material expression, and I'm going to type floor. And what a floor node does is it takes the value that is being input into it and rounds them down to the previous integer. So if you have something like 0.2, it's going to round it to 0.0. It winds up creating more of a faceted effect. So I'm going to plug this in here, and I'm going to plug this into our emissive channel. Now you can see it kind of has this random level of light. That looks good. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to compile my material. And our material is compiled. So to be able to create the light function, we need a dynamic light. And you can see right now that this is a dynamic light because we have a D/S for spotlight. So this is a dynamic spotlight. And it has a little chain right here because this is a toggleable light, which means you can turn it on and off. You can also use it with movable lights if you wanted to have like a swinging light, something like that. But I just wanted to have kind of this toggling light on and off. And this ring right here is because our lighting isn't built. So once we build our lighting, it'll look proper. So I'm going to delete this guy for just a second. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up our content browser. Here we go. And I'm going to go to our actor classes, and under spotlights, I'm going to grab a spotlight toggleable, and I'm going to drag it into the scene. So I'm just going to close this guy, and here's our spotlight toggleable. Bring this guy right over here. All right. And you can open up the properties by either right-clicking and hitting spotlight properties, or just double-clicking on the light. Now, I'm going to open up my light rollout and open up light component. And then once again, open up the light component, rollout. And right now, you can see that we have this function, and it says none. And this is actually where we're going to plug our light function into. So there's a little blue arrow, and we're going to click the blue arrow, which is going to create a new object, and we're going to create a light function. And now we have the ability to roll this out. And it sees source material none. So what we need to do is we need to plug a material into this function so we create our light. And we've already created our light function material, so let's just open up our content browser. And I'm going to select m_light function, and I'm just going to click the use selected object in content browser. So now that we have our light placed, and our material with our function placed inside of it, we're going to build our lighting. Now to do that, you just click the little light bulb right up here, and I'm going to turn it for build quality production, and this will only take a second because it's a small scene. And now that our lighting's finished being built, you could see that we have a really cool flickering light. Now you can change this up a little bit by changing, you know, the brightness, so you could set it to like 5 or something really bright and change the color, you know, if you wanted to have like a demon light or a blue light or for a rave. You know, you can have all sorts of different things that you can use to create these for. I just decided I wanted to create kind of something like a little bit of a Silent Hill deal. All right, well that concludes this lesson. If you have any comments or questions about the materials covered in this lesson, please don't hesitate to post on our forums, and check out our other videos, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com.